Hello everyone, welcome back. Now we are moving to the second set of the 5 questions of GATE 2017 question paper. And as you know, I am doing only the organic. And the next 5 organic questions happen to be question number 22, 23, 24, 25 and 41. So let's start with the question number 22. So it says, in the first 2-step reaction sequence given below, the starting bisulfonate, bis is like di, but when is already di is there, then we use the word bis. So bis is sometimes when we say when there is a double bond kind of thing, it acts as, okay. The choices given are a dienophile, a dienophile, a dipolarophile, a dipolarophile, first thing, and synthetic equivalent of acetylene and synthetic equivalent of ethylene. One thing is very clear, it will undergo Diels-Alder kind of reaction. So if it undergoes Diels-Alder kind of reaction, this will act as a diene, so this will act as a dienophile. So very clearly it will be either option A or option B. And then it says it is acting as a synthetic equivalent of acetylene or ethylene. So these both are common name. Acetylene is basically ethyne, okay. Ethylene is basically ethene. So we have to look into it. So you see here, first it undergoes a Diels-Alder reaction, you get this product, and you use sodium amalgam to remove this SO2PH and you get double bond. So then we'll find out what it is. It is acetylene equivalent or ethylene equivalent. Many of you might have got already. So first step is Diels-Alder reaction. This comes here and you get this, no doubt about it. So this is dienophile. And next step, what happens? Sodium amalgam has affinity for sulfur and removes sulfur. So the mechanism is goes something like this. This comes here and this goes out and you get a alkene. Now imagine if this alkene has to form, this double bond has to form from starting material. How it would be? This diene should be there and the dienophile should have been alkyne. Then only this will come here, this comes here, this comes here, and the double bond remains intact. So therefore, this molecule was equivalent to acetylene and not ethylene, and therefore the answer is option A. Okay, therefore the answer is option A. Moving on to the next question, answer option. Okay, next question also very direct question. It's very simple reaction. So it says the major product formed during the photochemical reaction is, so you are seeing ONO is there and HNU is there. So this is the famous Barton reaction. Incidentally, I have done postdoc with Professor David Kreitch when I was in Wayne State University, and he was PhD student of Professor Barton. So this is his reaction, who used to work on all these radical reactions. So you have this molecule and in photochemical reaction it is asking what is the product form. So this is Barton reaction. It is also called as Barton nitrite ester reaction. So in this, what you have to see basically is a 6-member ring is formed, transition state, and then it is used for remote functionalization. This was the first reaction where remote functionalization happened. Otherwise, whenever you see the reaction, either happens on the functional group or on the alpha carbon of the functional group. And if it is alpha beta unsaturated ketone, then there it may happen. But here it was happening on delta position quite far, so this is very important reaction, therefore it got a name and very repeatable reaction. So what you have to do is basically put ONO and see that oxygen will abstract a proton from that carbon so that it forms a 6-membered ring. You know, 6-membered ring is kinetically and thermodynamically both favored, and therefore if you look at here, you start counting from oxygen, alpha, beta, gamma, delta. So delta carbon gets functionalized. You have to remember this. Many times you may forget because so many things are there to remember, but 6-membered ring you cannot forget because 6-membered ring is both kinetically and thermodynamically favored. So that's how reaction happens in photochemical condition. You see O and nitrogen bond, they are very weak, so it immediately opens up, they both cleave and you get oxygen, and then oxygen picks up proton, you get OH. And then electron is there on this carbon. This reacts with the NO which has broken out. And this was the product what they expected us to know. So that is B. But generally, if you just get NO, what's the point? So lot of things you can do after that. Generally, it undergoes tautomerization. This comes here and you get oxime, and after oxime, you know, you can hydrolyze it, you can make ketone. So many things can be done. So this was another simple reaction. Next question is, this is simple again, Diels-Alder reaction. So the product formed in the following reaction is, so it's a Diels-Alder reaction, this is diene, this is dienophile. Diene is two alkenes and dienophile is simple alkene. And it says the product, so cis addition of both deuterium and trans addition, both are forming, or only trans is forming, or top trans, like top away from the viewer and below towards the viewer, or both of them will be in the cis. So that's what we have to know. So first thing is a Diels-Alder reaction. It's a concerted reaction. It happens in one step. It does not happen in two steps, so there is no chance of rotation. So the stereochemistry of reactant will be retained in the product. So this is the diene, this is dienophile. You understand there is a p orbital here and there is a p orbital here that will overlap with the p orbital on this one and overlap with the p orbital of this one. So they both overlap and that's how the bond is formed. Okay, so now let us look at the stereochemistry. So what happens? Now imagine if it is attacking from behind. So what will happen if it are attacking from behind? Will push both of them towards the viewer. Or you start looking from this side, that will make more sense. So if you look from this side, you will see that hydrogen is towards the viewer, deuterium is away from the viewer. Similarly, these two deuterium is towards the viewer and these two deuterium are away from the viewer. So anyway, on this carbon, two deuterium, these two deuterium will be away from the viewer and these two deuterium will be towards the viewer. These two hydrogen will be towards the viewer and these two deuterium will be away from the viewer. And that's what you get. You see, you get both hydrogen towards the viewer and both deuterium away from the viewer. So basically you are getting syn addition. Both deuterium has to be on the same face. Because I showed attack from behind, had I showed attack from front, I would have seen that deuterium was on top and hydrogen behind. This is exactly same actually. If you just rotate it 180 degrees like that, you rotate it like that. So what happens? Hydrogen goes behind, deuterium comes front. So this is what it is. What is the product? You get syn addition of the both deuterium and both hydrogen because the starting material was cis. Very important. If the starting material would have been trans, then you have got trans in the product also. That one deuterium front, one deuterium back. But starting material was cis. Both the deuterium are on the same face and both the hydrogens are on the same face, and therefore both the deuteriums at the end product will be in the same face, which is here. Okay, moving to the next question. The number of stereoisomers possible in cyclononine. Okay, so if cycloalkanes are there, okay, something like cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, up to 7, they can exist only in cis conformation, something like this. Okay, they cannot exist in trans. See, both hydrogens are here and both carbons are here. They cannot exist in trans because too much strain will happen. It will be like small ring is doing lot of gymnastics. But after 7 member ring, it can be trans also. So this is the cis and this is the trans. Now what happens when it is cis? You can very clearly see there is a plane of symmetry. So this is optically not active. Even if you draw mirror image, you will see that they are superimposable on each other. Whereas when it is trans, it does not have plane of symmetry. So if you draw the mirror image, you can see that these two are not superimposable. That means these two are two different molecules and therefore they show difference in property. And the difference is optical property. One will rotate in right, one will rotate the plane polarized light in left direction, and therefore these two are also isomers and this is another isomers. So the number of isomers possible are, stereoisomers possible are 3. Last question. In the following 3 alkanes, 1, 2 and 3, the rate of hydrogenation using Wilkinson catalyst at 25 degrees Celsius vary in the order. So you see this molecule 1 and 3 are very similar, only on methyl is there. So it's extra substituted. And this is cis alkene and this is trans alkene. Okay. So let's understand first how Wilkinson catalyst work. It basically works like catalytic hydrogenation. It will give you cis addition of hydrogen. You always get both the hydrogen added in the same phase. But good thing about Wilkinson catalyst is it is soluble in organic solvent because of this PPH3RHCl, and therefore this reaction faster, it is homogeneous. And how it happens is, this is initially 16 electron, so first is PPH3 goes away and you get 14 electron system, then H get added, both the hydrogen gets added, and then alkene coordinates with it so that it forms the, it completes the 18 electron rule, and then hydrogen gets added here, hydrogen gets added here, and you are getting this. Now what happens, you see, when the alkene is coming, it's coming in quite a bulky environment. So if more substituted alkene is there, it's tough for it to approach, and therefore less substituted alkene will get reduced faster than more substituted alkene. So very clearly between 1 and 3 you can say, 1 and 3 you can say that 1 will get reduced faster than 3, because 1 is less substituted than 3. This one, you see the substitution, this is disubstituted. Hydrogen is not considered a substituent. So on this double bond, this is one substituent, this is another substituent, two substituents. Similarly, here also two substituents. Hydrogen we don't consider, okay? So one substituent, two substituents. So this is also disubstituted. This one is having one hydrogen here, hydrogen not considered. So you're having one substituent, second substituent, and third substituent. So it is disubstituted. So between these three, this will be last one to get. Now the confusion is between 1 and 2. Now when you have to reduce between 1 and 2, the cis alkene gets reduced faster than trans. Why? It's basically like this. Cis is generally less stable than trans. Trans, you see, the bulkier groups are far from each other. They are quite stable. So now cis, imagine cis has this much stability, trans will be more stable, and both will have very similar transition state, something like this, okay, something like this here. Both of them, the transition state will be same, and product will be also very very similar. Now the thing is, fast speed of the reaction will be how fast this transition state is reached. Now cis is already unstable, so for it is much easier to reach this stage, because energy is high, little more energy, it comes to this energy. But this was stable, so for it to come up to here, you need more energy. And therefore, trans undergoes reduction slower than cis. So it's very clear now. Very clear now. Reaction fastest will be cis. So 1 will be fastest, faster than 2, than 3. So 1, 2 and 3. So the answer should be B. Okay. So that's it for today.